So I'm going to share a few stories with you today. The first is a story of control. I'm 14, I'm living in Madras, living my best high school life. I've fallen out of sync with my junior school friends. They were a source of support, source of strength. My grades were cause of concern to everybody but me. I was as into Eminem as I was Pink Floyd. I was doing pretty okay, but then I wasn't either. There was a boy that I was in love with. We'd speak on the phone for hours together, clearly in the friend zone. There were situations that I faced where I started to become the peacekeeper. I was getting overwhelmed. I didn't know how to deal with my emotions. I started to shove them deep down. I'd catch myself crying. I'd go to the mirror. I'd look at myself and say, what an idiot, laughing at you. Like, why are you crying? You can cry later. It's fine. You got stuff to deal with now. I started visualizing, compartmentalizing my emotions into these Tupperware boxes. So I'd keep thinking of what I was feeling and be like, I don't want to deal with it now. Started compartmentalizing it. It worked out great. I became the go-to person in type of any crisis. I was calm, I was confident, I was cool, and I was always in control. The second is a story of implosion. 20, back in Madras, Chennai by then. I had a huge circle of friends. I was doing exceedingly well at work. My family called me their beacon of light. 14-year-old me would be so proud. I was doing a lot of work outside, a lot of community engagement work. I was traveling a lot. I got to see Coldplay, I got to see Jay-Z. I was living a fantastic life. Then something happened. There was a situation, it caused me a lot of angst, and I started imploding, slowly, and then all at once. I started pulling away from my family. I started isolating myself from my friends. I stopped my community engagement. I was tired, I was exhausted, I was working harder than ever. My self-esteem was at an all-time low. I was hospitalized. It turns out I was clinically burnt out. I thought burnout at that point in time was just something that you face after a harrowing period. I didn't know it would lead to clinical conditions. As I lay in the hospital bed, I was asking myself, what happened? How did I get this way? How did I lose control? A recent study conducted found that 14 to 35 year olds in India, they found that 1 out of 14 responded with high emotional distress. 1 out of 4, moderate emotional distress. To questions on frequency of depression, loneliness, worthlessness, and suicidal ideation. India has the highest rate of youth suicide in the world. Every hour, a student is taking their own life. 9,500 annually. And suicide is just what you see at the tip of the iceberg. Underneath that, you have anxiety, you have depression, you have substance use. At the bottom of it all is overwhelming stress. It's the invisible daily emotional struggles that we go through. I was fortunate. I sought help. By my mid-20s, I was on my fourth therapist. I realized that I had depression. My teenage angst started to make sense. I hated the term depression. There was just, it just didn't sit with me. So I started calling it the meh, M-E-H, the meh. And that sat with me. I learned tools through therapy, through inner journey work, through healing, introspection, healing, on how to ride out the meh. One day, a friend wrote to me. He said he was in this deep, dark web of despair. He didn't know what to do and he really needed help. I told him it was okay, I was there for him, that we'd deal with it together. We spoke about his thoughts, his emotions, his behaviors. We spoke about therapy and other options. I started taking him through what I had gone through with the tools that I had used. And I saw his reactions to it. And that inspired me. It inspired me to create a kit, a self-discovery kit that we can all engage with. I call it the MEH kit. I saw the reactions and I realized that I had to do it justice. 50 wasn't enough. I created a crowdfunding campaign for it. We wanted to produce 350 kits. We met our goal in 6 days. By the 10th day, we had far exceeded our goal. Over 87 people contributed to this campaign. And this showed me that people were willing to invest in innovation and mental health. That they were looking to engage with their own silent emotional well-being in their own time. I wish 14-year-old me had access to this kit, that she could learn to engage with her emotions and express it. I wish the 20-something-year-old had access to this kit to learn how to speak to herself with kindness, compassion, and love. There are so many of us today who are imploding, who are exploding, who are shoving our emotions deep down, or who are just caught in these dark webs. And Mithra is my way of engaging with all of us. Look at the colors we've used, very light, warm colors, because depression is something scary, it's something heavy, but this kit is for you to engage with your own well-being. It's really light, warm, and full of love. So I have some of these kits. I can speak with you afterwards if you want to know more about it. You can follow us on Instagram, you can find us on Facebook, you can visit our website, you can come to Amani and catch up. Thank you.